Hello, I welcome you all. Now in previous video or previous lecture, we have started with the design of T-shaped retaining wall. In previous video lecture, we have started with the design of T-shaped retaining wall and the problem statement is here. Whereas in previous lecture, we have started with step 1, that is preliminary dimensions of preliminary dimensions of the retaining wall. Under that we have calculated the active earth pressure coefficient K, depth of the foundation DF. Further, we have assumed the dimensions according to the thumb rule. Then, we have drawn the retaining wall and pressure diagram according to the backfill condition, and backfill condition here was backfill with the surcharge. Hence, this will be the pressure diagram for the same. Then in step 2, we have given check for the stability. And check for stability we are given for 3 conditions. Check for stability against overturning. This was the check for stability against overturning. That is ratio of MS by M0, stabilizing moment to the overturning moment ratio should be greater than or equal to 0. So that retaining wall will be safe against overturning. We have calculated the weight. And these weights were calculated by dividing the retaining wall into different symmetrical components. Distance from the CG, that is from A point, that is far end of the toe, we have calculated, and this will act as lever arm, and multiplying this weight by lever arm we will get the stabilizing moment. In this way, these 5 components we have divided. You can go through the previous video. Then lever arms you have calculated respectively of that, and stabilizing moments were calculated, and total stabilizing moment came 437.25 kilonewton meter. Whereas P1 and P2 will be acting as lateral forces, and these lateral forces will lead to overturning moments. Hence, this will come under overturning moment calculation. In this way, we have calculated the active earth pressure, then lateral forces P1, P2, and calculated the overturning moment by multiplying the P1 into lever arm and P2 into lever arm. Hence, our factor of safety against overturning came less than 2. Hence, it indicates that section is unsafe in overturning. Now, as section is unsafe, we are supposed to revise the dimension. But prior to that, we have given factor of safety against sliding, and here also our retaining wall has failed against sliding. And in previous lectures, you can go through, there it was said that if section fails in sliding, then we are supposed to provide the shear key. And if you provide the shear key, automatically dead weight of the section will increase, and hence dead weight increases, then stabilizing moment will increase, and hence our ratio will automatically will come greater than 2. Hence it will become safe in overturning also. And if we are providing shear key, then our section will become safe against sliding also. This you will come to know when we will move step by step further. Next, we have given the check for maximum pressure at toe, and here also we have calculated maximum pressure and minimum pressure, that is maximum pressure at the far end of the toe and minimum pressure at the far end of the heel. Now we will move towards step number 3. Now our step number 3 is design of the toe slab. Design of the toe slab. Now this was our retaining wall. This is the toe, this is the heel, this is stem backfill with surcharge. Now as I have said in previous lectures, that this stem or retaining wall is nothing but resemblance of our foot and the leg portion. This will act as leg portion, this entire will act as foot portion, whereas these are nothing but toes, that is fingers of our foot, and the heel is nothing but rear end of our foot. And this is similar to our leg. Now we are supposed to design the toe slab. Now in toe slab we have considered only this toe portion. Only this much toe portion we have considered, and it is called as cantilever retaining wall because all these 3 components, toe, stem and heel, act as cantilever slab portion with these fixed ends. Now here we have considered only this toe portion having width of 1 meter, depth of 0.5 meter. W1 will be the load of the toe acting downwards at a distance x1 from B point. Here it is B point. As we have considered, this is fixed end, as we are supposed to design this toe as cantilever slab. And this will be the pressure diagram for the same. In this pressure diagram, maximum pressure we have calculated as 160.61 kN per meter square, whereas we are supposed to determine the maximum pressure at B. At this portion, we have not calculated any pressure. We have calculated pressure at A point and D point. Now sigma b will be unknown here. Now how you will determine the sigma b? Now we have determined sigma max and sigma minimum. Sigma b is nothing but pressure at the rear end or fixed end of the toe, and c will be nothing but pressure at the fixed end of the heel. Now we are supposed to determine sigma b. Now sigma b will determine by the interpolation formula. Sigma b is equal to 0 plus into bracket 160.61 minus 0 divided by 3 into 2. Now you might be knowing this interpolation calculation. You can go through this, whereas sigma b we have calculated as 107.607 kilonewton per meter square, and similarly we have calculated a sigma c with respect to the sigma max and sigma minimum values, and this sigma c value came 83.305 kilonewton per meter square. You might be knowing interpolation, or you can go through that and practice and calculate the intermediate values depending upon the far end values of the pressure. This formula you can keep in mind for trapezoidal. If you are supposed to determine the area of trapezoidal, formula is a plus b by 2 into h, and x bar you are supposed to calculate. X bar is nothing but the lever arm from the far end b, and it will be calculated as b plus 2a divided by a plus b into bracket h minus 3, whereas these two sides are named, this one side is named as a and second parallel side will be named as b. And if you are supposed to calculate the CG from the far end B, then your formula will be B plus 2A divided by A plus B into H by 3. And if you are supposed to calculate X bar from A, then your formula will be twice B plus A divided by A plus B. Here you should keep in mind, if you are supposed to calculate from B, then you should can take 2A, whereas if you are supposed to calculate from the A end, then you are supposed to consider 2B plus A divided by A plus B into H minus 3. This was just for your explanation. Now we'll move towards the design of the toe slab. Now this was the pressure diagram I have shown you previously. 0.5 is nothing but depth of the toe slab, and this is the pressure diagram sigma max, and sigma b we have calculated by the interpolation formula as seen previously. 1 meter is nothing but width of the toe slab. Now as you are knowing, this is the cantilever retaining wall, hence toe, stem and heel, all these three components will act as cantilever slab. Hence W1 will be the weight acting downward due to this dead weight of the slab, whereas W2 will be the upward force acting at a distance of x2 from the sigma b, that is fixed strain, and this W2 is nothing but upward pressure W2. Hence total net moment will be due to W1 minus W2. And if we calculate the moment, then you might be knowing to calculate the steel moment is required. Hence we'll be calculating the moment here one by one. Now we'll calculate W1. This W1 will be calculated. Now you might be knowing the rectangular formula, that is L by B, and we are calculating it for per meter length. Hence 0.5 is nothing but depth of the toe slab, 1 meter is nothing but the width, this 1 meter, 25 is nothing but unit weight of concrete, and 1 is nothing but perpendicular distance, that is per meter length of the slab. Hence W1 comes at 12.5 kilonewton acting at X1, that is X1 is nothing but, as it is symmetrical section, it will be 1 by 2, it comes to 0.5 meter. Now we will be calculating W2, and W2 is nothing but area of this trapezoid. Area of trapezoid is calculated by formula A plus B by 2, A is nothing but 160.61, B is nothing but 107.07 divided by 2 into H by 3, into H, where H is nothing but this base width, and it is nothing but 1. Hence W2 comes to be 133.84 kilonewton acting at X2. This W2 is acting at X2 from the beak, because we have considered this fixed strain, and hence we are designing this as cantilever slab. Then W2 will be acting from the support B, which is fixed strain, and X2. Now we are supposed to determine X2, and previously I have explained, if you are supposed to calculate the CG of trapezoid, then formula will be B plus 2A divided by A plus B into H by 3. And here H is nothing but the base width, 1 meter of this slab. And substituting all the values, here A is this parallel and B is this value. A is nothing but 160.61, B is nothing but 107.07, and H is nothing but base width. Substitute all these values, then you will get X2 as 0.53 meter from B. This X2 is nothing but 0.53 meter from B, and we have got these values by substituting all this, where A is nothing but sigma max, sigma B is nothing but B, and H is nothing but the base width of the trapezoid. Now we are supposed to calculate the moments. Now we'll calculate moment about B as 133.84 into 0.53 minus 12.5 into 0.5. Now 133.84 kilonewton force is nothing but W2 force, and its lever arm from the fixed end is 0.53, and 12.5 kilonewton force into lever arm is nothing but W1, and it is measured from fixed end B. And this net moment we are subtracting because one moment is acting upward, one moment is acting downward. That is, one will be clockwise moment, another will be anti-clockwise moment, and net moment will be resultant or algebraic summation of these. Hence, moment about B comes after calculation to be 64.70 kilonewton meter. Now we are supposed to calculate AST, that is nothing but steel, for moment of 64.70 kilonewton meter. Now ultimate moment will be factorized of this moment, that is 1.5 into 64.70. we are factorizing it here, ultimate moment, and it comes 97.05 kilonewton meter, that is MUD. Now you might be knowing cover for base slab, here it is assumed as 40 mm. Cover for stem, it is assumed as 50 mm. Now effective depth, as you are knowing, this is our toe portion, fixed end B, and this depth is nothing but 0.5 meter of the toe slab. Now effective depth of this will be 500 minus cover, that is 40 mm, minus diameter of bar divided by 2. Hence we will get effective depth. Now assume diameter of bar as 16 mm tor. Now assume diameter of bar as 16 mm tor. Then the effective will be 500 total depth minus cover minus 5/2, that is 16 mm tor we have assumed, and it comes to the effective as 452 mm. Now you all might be knowing this formula, 0.5 fck divided by fy into bracket under root 1 minus under root 1 minus 4.6 mud divided by fck bd square into bd. Now this formula you have studied or gone through in design of RCC structure. Then substituting all this value, AST is equal to 0.5 into fck, grade of concrete say 25, and fy 500. Substituting all this value, 1 minus 4.6 mud we have calculated, that is ultimate moment 97.05 kilonewton meter, and converting into newton mm multiply by 10^6. And fck we are considering m25 grade of concrete, though in question it was given as m20. Consider here fck as m25 and steel as Fe 500, because nowadays Fe 415 steel or M20 grade of concrete is not utilized. Mostly it is preferred M25 grade of concrete and Fe 500 steel. Hence consider Fy here 500. Substituting all this value, we will substitute FCK as 25. B will be nothing but effective depth, and that comes B is nothing but per meter length. B is nothing but per meter width of the slab, that is 1000 mm, and D is nothing but effective depth, and that we have calculated as 452 square multiplied by B into D. B is nothing but 1 meter width, and D is effective depth nothing but 452. Now in calculation of these we get AST as, now in calculation of this our AST comes 505 mm square. Now this AST should be greater than AST minimum. You might have gone through design of RC structure in the previous academic year. Now AST should be greater than AST minimum. Now we will calculate AST minimum. Now you might be knowing the formula for the AST minimum calculation, that is nothing but 12% of the area, that is nothing but 0.12 divided by 100 into BD. 0.12 is nothing but 12%. B is nothing but per meter width, and D is nothing but total depth of the section divided by 100, and this AST minimum comes 600 mm square. Now as AST provided is not greater than AST minimum, that is AST provided was 500 mm square and AST minimum is 600 mm square. Now we are supposed to consider this minimum steel of 600 mm square. Hence, provide AST of 600 mm square. Now for the 600 mm square, we are supposed to calculate the spacing. Therefore, spacing SV is equal to AST divided by AST into 1000. Here small AST is nothing but area of the bar. This AST is nothing but area of steel that is to be provided into 1000. Now area of the bar, we have assumed bar diameter as 16 mm square, hence pi by 4 d square, that is 16 square divided by AST, as we are supposed to provide maximum of these 600 into 1000, and our spacing comes near about 335 mm, near about 335 mm. Now SV we have calculated as 335 mm, and it should not be greater than 3D or 300 mm, whichever is less. And hence, as the spacing is greater than 300 mm, we are supposed to provide spacing of 300 mm. This clauses you might have gone through in structural design of RCC structures. Hence, provide tor 16 at 300 mm center to center at bottom of toe slab as main reinforcement. Now in previous lectures, you can go through the videos of this introduction part of retaining wall. There I have said that deflection of this T-shaped retaining wall is of somewhat this nature. Here tension is at the bottom in case of toe portion. In case of heel portion, tension is at top, and in case of stem, tension is on inner part. Now role of reinforcement is to carry tension, and hence this toe reinforcement, main reinforcement of the toe, will be provided at the bottom, that is here, bottom of the toe section. For detailed explanation, you can go through the previous videos. Now we are supposed to calculate the distribution steel, that is ASD, and it is nothing but 12% of the area, and it comes to 600 mm square. Assume diameter of 10 mm tor for distribution steel, hence spacing will be 1000 AST by AST, 1000 into pi by 4 into d square divided by distribution steel area that is to be provided will be 600, and hence spacing comes to 131 mm. It should not be greater than 5D or 450 mm. Now our spacing is less than this, hence we'll provide 130 mm spacing. Now hence provide tor 10 at 125 mm spacing center to center as distribution steel in toe slab, as distribution steel in the toe slab. Now in this way we have designed the toe slab. In this way we have designed the toe slab, where we have calculated the moments, that is net moment. One moment we have calculated due to the dead weight of the toe slab, where a second moment was due to the upward pressure, and resultant of this moment algebraic calculations, we have calculated the net moment acting, and depending upon that net moment, we have calculated the AST, and it should be greater than AST minimum. And next we have assumed 10 mm diameter for distribution steel, and we have calculated the ASD. ASD is nothing but 0.12 BD by 100, and for that we have calculated the distribution steel spacing, and hence we have provided 10 mm tor at 125 mm center to center as distribution steel in the toe slab. Now in this way we have designed the toe slab. In the upcoming video, we'll design the hill slab. Till then, you can go through these two videos of design of T-shaped cantilever retaining wall. For any doubts, you can go through the notes. Link for the notes is provided in the description box, or comment your doubts in the comment box for any doubts. Now, in upcoming video, we'll start with the design of hill slab. Till then, thank you very much.